Hey guys, you probably already know that one of the main benefits of having an Android head unit or an AI box in your car is that you can install pretty much whatever you want on them. But from the sea of available Android apps, what should you install that would benefit you in your car? Yes, it's that video that you've been asking me to do for ages. Let's look at some apps. If you're on the lookout for an Android head unit, look no further than this video sponsor. Yes, that's right. For the first time ever, I have a video sponsor, CarTechStudio.com. They're based in the USA in Delaware and specialize in premium high quality head unit infotainment systems to modernize your cars by adding all the sought after features that you want, such as Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and of course, installing the apps that we're going to be talking about in this video. CarTechStudio supply premium Android 12 based head units, which importantly have those excellent speedy specifications that you guys have come to expect. These head units have the ability to integrate into car systems such as steering wheel controls, and in many cases will display other information about your AC temperature and heated seats, etc. The head units are supplied for specific car trims to make the installation completely clean and factory looking. Or if your car isn't listed on their website, they can provide a universal variant for custom installation. They even do these awesome Tesla style vertical displays that not only replace existing factory car radios, but also their original AC controls to give you a completely new, modern, factory looking installation. They ship worldwide and provide a full year warranty on all products. So check out their website, make sure that you use the code SAABUNLEASHED50 to get $50 off your order. As these Android head units are getting more and more popular, people are looking to see how to get the most out of them. These devices offer complete freedom from the restraints of Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. Now, there's no doubt in my mind that some of you watching this video are confusing Android head units with the more basic Android Auto streaming technology, and that's fine. Those of you who are using factory car radios or the likes of Kenwood, Pioneer, Sony, and the other big brand units which support Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, this video is still relevant to you, but you will need to get yourself one of these, an AI box, which essentially turns your car head unit into an Android head unit and ultimately lets you install almost any apps that you could possibly want. The best one that I've tested is this Carlinkit Max, and I'll leave a link in the video description with a discount code so you can pick one up if you want. So we know that YouTube, Netflix, etc. can be installed, but they're not really car related. So what interesting stuff could you install? Well, let's start with radio and the best FM radio app. It's not a secret that Android head units generally have pretty basic FM radio software, some of which don't even show RDS radio station names, which is a personal irritation of mine. So this is where Nav Radio Plus comes in. This is an app that has been meticulously designed to offer the best experience with FM radio, and yes, it does actually use the built-in FM tuner hardware in your FYT head unit. However, it's not compatible with all hardware variants. For this reason, you should download the free version from the Play Store to check compatibility. My favorite feature of this radio app is that you can quickly and easily download and extract the station logos for your specific country. It also offers a few different interface options so you can choose the one that you like. My personal preference is the carousel. What you're left with is an excellent way to browse your stations with a beautiful modern interface with buttons to all relevant radio settings, including a shortcut to your head unit's equalizer. When it comes to DAB, some head unit manufacturers have their own built-in software and some require you to download it for yourself. For those of you who don't know, DAB stands for Digital Audio Broadcast, and it is the digital radio standard in Europe, Australia, and a few other countries. It's important to remember that every Android head unit is compatible with DAB, but you will need to plug one of these in. These are USB DAB tuners. I've found that the best DAB app is DABZ. I've chosen DABZ because it still has continuing development and offers a pleasing user interface that has the station artwork, and that just makes it a pleasure to navigate. Lastly, I want to take a moment to talk about the subscription-based SiriusXM, the satellite radio technology in the US of A. I get asked quite often if there are any Android head units that have SiriusXM capable hardware. And the answer is unfortunately no. There is also no USB add-on to enable Sirius, and I assume that's to do with licensing. But there is a SiriusXM streaming app to enable you to access all your favorite stations and podcasts, which can be installed on your Android head unit. This app uses your mobile data connection to stream the stations to your car. I'd love to demonstrate it to you, but unfortunately it's blocked outside of the USA, even with a VPN. Now, staying on the subject of car audio and something that I personally use every day, Project M Music Visualizer. I have fond memories of the good old Max Power days when the best car audio hardware had various animations that danced along to the music that you were playing. Or if you never had one of those, do you remember the MP3 player Winamp on your PC that had an awesome music visualizer plugin called Milk Drop? Or maybe that's just me. So Project M Music Visualizer is just that. It provides high resolution visuals to your music, and I absolutely love it. Especially if you're running an Android 12 or above device that allows split screen. So you can have Spotify or navigation open with the visuals open on the same screen. It's also great when your head unit launcher has a window that allows you to run an app of your choice, because it means it starts up ready for you to use as soon as you turn your car on. Now, it's probably not the best app to have if you are easily distracted behind the wheel, but it's great if you have passengers. Which brings me to the last audio related apps. You will already know that you can install the likes of Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube, Deezer, Tidal directly onto the head unit. One is not necessarily better than the other. It just depends on your taste for user interface and, of course, who you are currently paying your subscription to. I can already hear some of you shouting through the screen that Tidal or Apple Music is better due to the studio quality bitrate compatibility. However, when you factor in the fact that your head unit's audio stack probably has its own limitation of only CD quality, 16-bit, 48Hz, it really makes no difference from one app to the other. That being said, for those audiophiles amongst us who have a meticulously tuned car audio system installed, it is actually possible to install a USB DAC onto your Android head unit, such as this industry-leading hifi Zen One Signature, enabling full 24-bit, 192Hz studio quality audio. But this video is to talk about apps, and if you want to output to a DAC, you'll be wanting to use either USB Audio Player Pro or Neutron Music Player, both of which contain drivers and the ability to bypass the head unit hardware to output purely to your USB DAC. However, it is by no means as simple as that, and this subject actually warrants its own video. So I will be doing a full high definition audio install via Android head unit soon on this channel. Okay, so before we talk about navigation, let's talk about the ability to view your car's data on the head unit screen. To do this, you will need something called an ELM327 ODB2 reader, which on most cars will plug in underneath your steering wheel. This will connect via Bluetooth or Wi-Fi to your head unit or AI box and share live technical data about your car. The good news is that they're fairly cheap, and I'll leave a link in the video description if you want one. So I've got two go-to apps when I want to look at car data. The first is, of course, Talk Pro. This is really cool as it actually allows you to design the dashboard exactly as you want it, with clocks and graphs showing specific stats that you want to see. There's really no limit to what can be displayed, from a simple rev counter or speedometer to advanced technical data such as your boost pressure. And of course, beyond all of that, it will even allow you to read the car's error codes on the actual head unit itself, and you can even clear those codes as well. The other app that you probably find interesting is Car Scanner ELM ODB2. This doesn't have the graphical interface of Torque, as it's more geared towards diagnostics. And I personally used it to measure the power consumption of different driving styles in my Mustang Mach-E electric car. One of the other great features of this app is that it records live data along with your GPS location, so you can see exactly what your car was doing at any given time without actually having to take your eyes off the road. Okay, let's talk about navigation. The absolute king of navigation apps is Waze. And the main reason for this is the accuracy in which it reroutes you around traffic, which it knows about by taking data from other Waze users who are in traffic. The ETA in Waze is also the most accurate, because if you have an account, it will actually learn your driving style. So if you constantly drive either below or above the speed limit, Waze accounts for this in its ETA, along with other projected traffic and other factors. Waze also offers the best driver notifications. It highlights upcoming potholes, roadworks and police speed traps. All of these reports originate from other Waze users, so it has this little community to keep everyone informed of everything that could potentially affect your driving. Now, my personal backup is, of course, Google Maps, which does offer a sharper and higher resolution map, and it does offer traffic and speed camera warnings too, just not as well as Waze does. But I find that Google Maps is better when I'm searching for a place of interest, which I don't know the address of. Another very important aspect of Google Maps is that it can be used totally offline, as it offers the ability to download areas of the map directly onto the Android head unit or AI box. Just remember that offline usage does reduce it to a no-frills navigation without traffic, roadworks, rerouting. For those of us who occasionally drive electric cars, there is one app that rules them all for finding chargers, and that is ZapMap. ZapMap has by far the most accurate up-to-date information on the status of chargers. Now, there's nothing more frustrating than navigating to a charger to find it's already in use or it's out of order. And ZapMap prevents this from happening, and it's far more effective than any of the other apps that I've tested. You can also just filter the fast chargers, and this is what I do. I will find the nearest charger that's more than 100 kilowatt per hour. I'll tell you a secret about ZapMap. You need a subscription to use it with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. But if, like us, you have a real Android head unit or AI box, if you install ZapMap directly onto your device, you can use all the services completely free of charge. You're welcome. Now, as we come to the end of this video, I should probably mention a very important group of apps, which I haven't mentioned, and that is, of course, the launcher. And that is the main user interface of the Android head unit or the AI box that you can actually download off of the Google Play Store so that you can get a much nicer look and feel of the Android head unit or AI box. Now, I've done a whole video on which launcher softwares I find are the best, which I'll link in the video description. But just so that you know, I will be releasing another launcher video showing the very latest launchers in the near future. And with that, I'll end the video. If there's any apps that you think that should have been on this list which I have missed, please do let me know and I'll have a quick look. And of course, any other questions that you might have, just pop them in the comment section below and I'll see what I can do. Until next time.